This is Robert Kraft, and I'm your host on Planet Microcap. And joining me right now is Marc-André Pelletier. He's the president, CEO, and director of Bonterra Resources, publicly traded company. I got two symbols for you, BTR on the TSX Venture and BONXF on the OTCQX. And Bonterra will be presenting at the upcoming Precious Metal Summit Beaver Creek, happening September 13th through 16th, 2022. For more information, please go to precioussummit.com. And with that, Marc-André, thank you so much for joining me today. How are you doing?
Good day, Robert. I'm doing great. Good. Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too. And again, thank you for joining. So this is actually our first time doing an interview together. We've interviewed Bonterra before, but you are new management in the company. So before we get into all the new changes, highlights, milestones, all that good stuff, you know, can you provide us that quick overview of Bonterra and then we'll go from there?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Robert. Bonterra is a junior gold exploration company. We are within the Abitibi Greenstone Belt in the north of Quebec, particularly in the Urban-Barry Camp, which is a very strategic camp. What makes Bonterra apart compared to our peers is we do have a very large resources of over 3 million ounces of gold, but we do also have infrastructures. We have the only permitted mill in the Urban-Barry Camp. And we recently published a PEA, Preliminary Economical Assessment, one of our projects, and we're quite excited about it.
All right, well, let's find out a little bit more. You know, like I said, we last had management on here in August 2021. Clearly, there's, you know, you're the new head honcho over there. So tell us a little bit about maybe some of your background. And then also, let's continue on that conversation about the recently announced PEA and why this was transformative for the company.
Yeah, so my background is mining engineering. I have over 25 years of experience now, mostly in gold, open pit and underground. And when in the last 10 years, I was able to facilitate the reopening of new mines or old projects. That's kind of my expertise, you know. Reopen 4 underground mines and 1 open pit in the last 10 years. Most recently, I was part of the West Dome story 5 years ago when we, you know, increased the production at the Eagle Mine to basically finance the development of the Kiena project. And that kind of approach, Robert, you know, increase the production, increase the cash flow, and grow the business organically, it is the wisdom story, but it is the same kind of story I would like to do at the Bonterra. Basically, a bootstrap approach, you know, start small, and grow the business. So since I joined the company mid-January, one of the things, you know, I spent some time to look at the business, our land packages, and we put together a kind of a new strategy well aligned with our board of director, which is to move the company from advanced exploration to development to production restart. And I took the time, you know, to look at our projects. And in February, we initiated a PEA on the Baggy Open Pit project.
So Marc-André, yeah, tell us a little bit more about that PEA.
Yeah, so one of the thing when we did the technical review of our projects, we realized our projects are not all at the same stage of development. And by far, the Baggy Open Pit project is the most advanced of our project. Gladiator project, which contains over 1.4 million ounces of gold, will eventually come, you know, into production, but it's more a 5 to 8 years horizon. Baggy Open Pit and Baggy Underground contains altogether near 1.3 million ounces. But what's make Baggy Open Pit more ahead is basically almost all of the resources are in the measured and in the indicated category, which means a higher confidence of, you know, of level. And we can convert those resources as reserves through a PFS. So basically for the Bergy open pit, it contains 150,000 ounces of gold, which is only 10% of the Bergy deposit. However, it's all in measured and indicated. And that means that no more diamond drilling is required to define that ore body. So we get pretty good confidence on the ore body. The PEA we just released, 150,000 ounces, 5 years life of mine. So it's we're talking about 30,000 ounces a year. Because Bonterra has the infrastructures, we have the mill, we have roads, we have camp, water management facilities. The initial capital to start the production at Bergy is fairly modest. We're talking about $21 million Canadian. And the life of mine capital is 50 million. So basically half and half initial and sustaining capital. So it's not, fairly modest capital. The intention, the strategy, if I can say, for Bonterra is to reinvest the cash flow that we are going to generate from the open pit into the underground resources, which contains 1.2 million ounces. So as you can see, we have the bootstrap approach. We want to start the production at the pit next year. We would, and all the cash generated will be invested in the Bergy underground. And we would like to bring the underground operation into production in a 3 to 5 years horizon. So as you can see, we have a pretty clear strategy on what we want to do to advance our Bergy project ahead.
Very good. And then, from what you can tell us, what are the next steps then, right? You got the PEA, you got the strategy in place. All right, we know how much you need. Now what?
Yes, good question. So we, right after the PEA, we started a PFS, which is a pre-feasibility study. So that study is required to convert the resource as reserves. And we're hoping to get that PFS completed by the end of this year. In my mind, it's a fairly simple project, an open pit. It's not a big pit, 100 meters deep, a good resource there. And there's been some past production there as well as open pit mining method. So all the ore was processed at the Bachelor Mill, which is the same mill, which is our mill. So we don't expect a lot of changes into the PFS, but we're going to take, all the effort necessary to reduce the risk. And then that's our business, and that's mining. It's a risky business, but we're going to advance the technical studies, to reduce the risk as much as possible. So that's happening now, Robert. Another very important aspect of our business is the permitting. And we've been in permitting process for a few years already to upgrade our mill from 800 tons capacity to 2,400 tons capacity. However, in the PEA, we consider to proceed to the upgrades in phases. So in the PEA, we made the assumption that we will process the ore at a tonnage of 1,200 tons per day. So we want to do it in phases. We are also working on what I call the detailed engineering. So we need to work on the detailed engineering for the mill. There's going to be some work required to increase the tonnage to 1,200 tons a day. And one of our biggest capital investment, the 50 million that I talked previously, 20 million is going to be spent at the tailings management area, which is located right next to the Bachelor Mill. And we need to advance the detailed engineering there in order to get our permits. So all that work is happening this year. I mentioned the Bergy underground. We need to move to the definition drilling program now. So that's happening as we speak. We actually have two diamond drills, basically focusing on the definition of the underground deposit. So basically, just a quick resume, so we're going to complete the PFS this year. At the same time, we're advancing the detailed engineering for the mill and the TMA expansion, which are the two big projects that will be very important to happen next year before the restart. Permitting process is takes time. We are in the James Bay region of Quebec. It triggers actually a second layer of permitting. So we actually have to go through two layers of permitting, and we are in the first layer stages. All the detailed engineering that I mentioned will be used when we're going to be at the second layer of permitting, which is at the provincial level. So we're hoping to get our permits in hand basically a year from now, mid-July next year. And the PA was based on the production restart in July. So really, as you can see, we have a year and a half ahead of us. We're going to be very busy. The pit, because of the past production, we have a lot of waste to strip to get the pit to the right place at the start. And we're hoping to start producing some ore at the mill, some gold, in October next year. So,
all right.
So by the end of next year, we should have a gold bar in our hand.
With Bonterra right on it. So
BTL-001.
Yeah, there you go. So Marc-Andre, with that, where can our audience go and find more information on Bonterra?
Of course, you can go on our website, BTR Gold, Bonterra Resources. I mentioned the PEA. We basically released the highlights. The 43-101 PEA document will be filed on our website by the end of July. So that's going to be, it's a technical document, but if you want to get more details, I will ask you to refer to that document at the end of July.
Very good. Well, Marc-Andre, thank you so much for joining me today. I really do appreciate it. Good luck. Stay safe. And I look forward to our next update.
Same to you, Robert. Thank you.
Thank you. And Bonterra Resources will be presenting at the upcoming Precious Metal Summit Beaver Creek, happening September 13th through 16th, 2022. For more information, please go to preciousummit.com.